Hey everyone, welcome back to Introduction to Bifrost Visual Programming. In the previous tutorial, we created bonfires using aerial simulation. Today we're going to use an alternative way to source air properties with the recently released Bifrost 2.4. This new version allows us to use fields to specify properties for aerial simulations, and we can now plug fields directly into influence nodes, which we'll learn in this tutorial. Bifrost 2.4 also introduces Bifrost USD and includes various other improvements. You can upgrade to 2.4 if you're using Maya 2020 or above. There's a link to the download page in the description. Without further ado, let's get started. Last time we used the VariSource property node to introduce variations in fog density and temperature. This time, let's see how to use fields to drive the changes in air properties. Delete the VariSource property nodes and animate source geocompound. Connect the mesh spheres to source air and change the geovolume mode to shell so that only the surface of the mesh will be voxelized, which will speed up the simulation. Let's get a fractal noise field. As we learned in the last tutorial, we can use a scalar field to provide the time. To control how fast the noise animates, we multiply the frame with a value. And then connect it to the scalar field. The range of the noise is from negative 1 to 1, and we can use an F-curve field to modify the range. For example, if we want the temperature to fluctuate between 180 and 250 Celsius, we set the lowest position to be negative 1 and assign 180 to its value. Set the highest position to be 1 and enter 250 for the value. Click this Frame All button to reframe the modified curve. Connect the out field to temperature. This diagram shows how an F-curve field changes the range of a noise field. Similarly, we can modify the range and apply it to the fog density. Copy and paste the F-curve field. Set the value of the lowest position to be 0.1 and the value of the highest position to be 0.25. Connect it to fog density. This setup, compared to the VariSource property node, allows more control over the details of how a property varies, and it also makes for a simpler graph. For example, we can adjust the frequency of the noise. The seed, as well as the shape of the F-curve to modify how the air properties change over space. To better visualize the variations driven by fields, we can use the node scalar field scope or vector field scope, depending on the type of the field. I'll do a quick demonstration here. Let's copy the node that we used for setting up the field animation. Paste them into a new graph. Drag Bifrost Graph 1 into this new graph. And let's copy this translate points as well. connect mesh fire to points, and this gives us the same mesh spheres as those in the other graph. Turn off the fire graph for now. And let's get a scalar field scope and a terminal. Connect out field to scalar field, and the mesh spheres to probe geometry. Let's decrease the point size, and now we see the noise pattern. We can adjust the color remap curve here to modify the colors. The range that we set up for the fog density is between 0.1 and 0.25. So let's enter 0.1 for the first point and 0.25 for the second point. Now the range of the field values at the sample positions is aligned with the default color range. We can modify the RGB curves to adjust the colors. If we change the frequency of the noise, the seed, or the F curve, we see the corresponding changes in the color pattern. If we animate it, we see this continuous change over time. We can adjust the multiplier here to modify the rate of the change. Now let's hide this graph and go back to the fire. Run the simulation, and the evolving values will trigger a continuous variation in both the temperature and fog density, and we see the variations in both time and space. Here's a rendered animation of the scene. This setup also allows us to quickly alter the look of the object to test different design ideas. For example, we can convert the bonfires into fireballs, as shown in this picture, in just a few steps. Here the hollow part is where the fog density equals zero. The fog density range that we have right now is from 0.1 to 0.25. To convert it into a discrete set of zeros and positive numbers, we can first change the value of the lowest position of the F-curve to be a negative number, say negative 0.25. And then use the node mask field, which returns 1 where the input scalar field is positive and 0 everywhere else. If we multiply it with a scalar field of 0.1, the fog density will be either 0 or 0.1, depending on the location. Let's go to the Aero Solver settings, change the buoyancy to 0. Move the mesh spheres up. And decrease this number to slow down the animation of the fractal noise field. Run the simulation, and we get the fireballs. In Bifrost 2.4, we can also plug fields into influence nodes. For instance, if we add a turbulence influence, we can plug a field directly into this turbulence port. Let's try fractal turbulence field. Copy and paste the scalar so that we have separate control of the animation speed for this fractal turbulence field. Connect the scalar field to time, and we'll have an evolving turbulence influence driven by the animated fractal turbulence field. To visualize the animation of the fractal turbulence field, we can use a vector field scope. Let's copy these nodes into the visualization graph that we created earlier. Get a vector field scope. Similar to the setup for visualizing a scalar field, we connect the field to vector field and the mesh spheres to probe geometry. Connect the diagnostic geo to the terminal. We can adjust the length and the width of the vectors and the base brightness. If we change, say, the frequency and the magnitude of the fractal turbulence field, we'll see the changes in the vectors and their colors. And we can adjust the point values of the color remap curve as well. Run the animation, and we see the motion of the vectors. Now let's go back. Increase the frequency and the magnitude of the fractal turbulence field. Run the simulation. And the result is a different pattern from the one we had earlier. To increase the negative space, we can simply adjust the F-curve field by decreasing the value of the lowest position so that we have more negative values in the field. Now we have completed the scene of our landscape. I hope this tutorial series helps you get started in Bifrost visual programming. We'll have more Bifrost tutorials coming in the near future. Comment below if you have any questions and let us know what you would like to learn. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, and we'll see you soon.